Hi all, I think most of the KLites are familiar with Sapna Nasruddin Nayyar, who secured 45th rank in her first attempt. So today we have the very charming, vibrant, determined, enthusiastic Sapna Nasruddin Nayyar with us. Thank you ma'am, and we are so pleased to have you for our channel, to have your views. And ma'am, I think most of the KLites are familiar with you, with your preparation, your visions. And you were always telling that I would like to be an empathetic and sincere one in this field. So can you have any such experiences, or what are the impressions that you have in your field now when it comes to execution?
So there are a lot of scope to work. I had joined the Malappuram around 3 months back. So mostly I had been in COVID related work since the start. I was working in DPMSU. So mostly I have been associated with COVID related work, and there itself I had seen that we used to get ventilator calls, we used to get ICU calls, and our team, as a team, we had arranged from DPMSU all these facilities. So mostly these 3 months I had been in around COVID related work.
Okay, this was a satisfying, is there any satisfying moment or you felt like?
Obviously, when you related to COVID work, if somebody approaches with any request and if we are able to arrange it, it is definitely a satisfying moment. Other than that, also I had been to field visit. I had talked to different sections of people, but that all were part of my training. So I had interacted with people in a very open manner. I had talked to them. So that has been the experience so far. Interacting with people and some
and that
COVID
marks
work.
Your career too.
Okay. I had done it the past 3 months.
Okay ma'am, and especially students are looking forward to IAS, and they are always eager to know how to prepare. And as an inspiration, or being a lady representative, what do you would like to tell to the students, or your message, those who are seeking to become a civil servant officer?
Is it to a general public?
To the students.
My message has always been this, that be disciplined and consistent to everyone. My message would always be honest in your preparation. See, this is an examination where you have to spend more than 2 years of your life. So it is easy to study for a day, for a week, or for a month. But to have that same enthusiasm, same motivation, same consistency in your preparation for around 2 months, 2 years, that is going to be difficult. So my message has always been, be disciplined in your preparation, be consistent in your work, and believe in your journey. And remember that no one is perfect. Everybody will have issues. Even throughout my preparation journey, if I analyze, I had issues. I had issues with solving prelims, be it prelims question or mains answer, or even in interview, I had a lot of issues. But this is a journey where you have to improve yourself. Every day is a learning experience. But the point is, you have to understand what your issue is and you have to correct it. And that, I believe, is the most crucial thing in this journey.
Okay ma'am, so consistency matters when you
consistency
prepare.
Consistency matters, and that confidence also.
Yes, and be honest with your...
Be honest and be confident also. If you are not confident, then it's difficult. If you do not believe in yourself, then no one else will believe you.
And ma'am, when it comes to the socio-political scenario of Kerala, we know that there are a number of issues against women, like the dowry issues. Though we are living in 2021, like Vismaya, Utra, there are a number of issues against women. Or women are some kind of limited or restricted to speak out. Nowadays, women are coming up. So, as a woman, ma'am, what do you would like to tell to the women folk, that how should we mold ourselves to be bold or to face the challenges that are coming across with?
This is a societal problem which requires effort from different segments. First is the women. Study and be independent. That would be the first message. You study and you stand. You are able to stand on your own legs. You have that economic empowerment. That is the first message I want to tell women.
Financial stability.
Financial stability plus, see, education transforms you as a person. Education is not about you studying so many things and remembering that and writing an examination. Education corrects your stereotypes or make you more bold, make you realize things from different perspective. So that will change that person in entirety. So first is education. Women should get education. But for that, I don't know whether I should say this or not, but many of the parents I have seen, they give preference to marriages and marriages more than their education. I have come across girls who get married at a very younger age and are not able to pursue their education. So my message or my request to the parents would be to support your children, especially if your girls wants to study. Do not ask them to go marry at a young age and stop their studies. Without parental support, it is difficult. There is a limit up to which we can fight against our own family. So that family support is very crucial. And my message would be to the parents out there, to support your children, to support your girls. If they do not want to get married now, don't force them.
Let them study.
Let them study. Let them pursue their.
Obviously, ma'am. Yeah, you have an influential parents in your life, or influential moments like. Are those who gave you the strength? So can you have something to tell about your family or the backbone?
Definitely my family. Without family support, I will not be here today. My parents had always prioritized education over anything. I have two elder sisters. Both of them have been supporting throughout this phase. So it is, family support is very crucial. Had they not been there, I don't think I would be here today. So family support and the support of my teachers and friends, everything had been crucial throughout my life.
Okay, then what's your impression about Malappuram?
Malappuram is a very good place. If my entire staff and colleagues in collectorate is very warm, very warming, and they are very good. They are very efficient. So I'm happy. I'm happy with the place. I'm happy with my colleagues here. The entire populace. Everybody is so welcoming and okay. So warm.
And we are so happy to have you as well, ma'am.
Same here.
And ma'am, one more question that I would like to ask. Once in Prashant's note, I read that he visited Kudiravattam Mental Health Center, where he noticed a number of inequalities going on there, or their food was not in a proper manner. So have you noticed any such things in your career or in your lifetime, or what are the fields you would like to really want to get involved with? Is it women empowerment? Or something like that. Do you have any specific
specific two areas I would like to work with? This women empowerment and education. These are the two areas that I would like to work with. On the first part, whether I had seen inequalities, all of us had. If you ask me, all of us, you just go from one place to another in that road journey itself, or meet any journey itself, you'll see inequalities and differences and issues. So there are a lot of scope to work, but areas that I would like to work is women and children and education.
Okay, ma'am. One more question that which I come across in my mind. We know that we have a very vast kind of social media culture. So what's your take on the social media culture? Because we have the cancel culture or attacking someone with the social media. And I think you locked your FB profile. That's a private space for you, I think. So what's your take on this? Social media, as a tool for change making, and at the same time, a tool for something, unfavorable things. So what's your take on this?
You have actually answered the entire question itself. Social media is a boon as well as a bane. There the advantages with the social media is you can get your message across. If there is a scheme by the district administration or at a state level, we are launching an initiative to connect with the people, especially from an administrative point of view, it is easier to connect with the people using social media. But the disadvantages or the issues are there. Definitely there are issues with social media. There is a cyber bullying trend, there is a stalking issue. Everybody can voice their opinion in social media. So without understanding the real issue, people might come up with their own point of view. It's not an issue. Coming up with your point of view is not the issue, but that cyber bullying is really a matter of concern.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you. So, and overall, what do you think? How our children should be molded, or what are the guidance we should give to the children from a very young early age onwards? Or do we have to implement certain things in our education system, like Santosh Jotsar once said, a traffic awareness in once in a week in our syllabus. So, do you have any such plans or any such things to share with us? something in your mind that you noted down, okay, if this comes, it will be better for our generation?
Education has to be comprehensive. That is it. It is not like you include one module or two module regarding any topic that will change. But education has to be comprehensive. Along with what we teach them, we have to ensure that we instill the right kind of values in them. Teaching them maybe science, maths or social science, along with that you have to inculcate values in them. You have to tell them what humility is, what honesty is, what hard working is. So you have to instill, you have to teach them to be kind, to be patient. So these are the values that you have to instill in the children along with what you teach them, along with the academic curriculum. Instill the values in children.
Okay, be human, that's the whole concept.
That is the message to everybody, not just children. Be human, that is the message to everyone out there.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you.